If Garrett Cole had made the rotation out of spring training, guy, they would have had 82 wins about a month ago. If you would have listened to me.
If Garrett Cole would have made the rotation out of spring training, he'd have blown out his arm by now, wouldn't even still be in the rotation.
82, baby. Finally is here last night. Nobody quite knew when to expect it after the bludgeoning this weekend in St. Louis, but it's finally arrived. You lived as a professional through all 20 years of this guy. How are you feeling this morning?
Yeah, feeling great.
I noticed your P's the right setup.
You had the right side. I had the upside down one on yesterday, which no one asked about, but a guy had mailed us that hat from China. That was a mistake, actually, when we were doing the ESPN show. And then, you know, the Reds go out and lose to the Cubs. So that's the way it goes, Ken. I mean, I'm sure their fans today are like, how can you take 3 out of 4 off the Cardinals and sweep the Dodgers and then lose to the Cubs? And that's my biggest fear. You know, get through this Texas trip. I'm counting on them having a good 11-game homestand. They've been really good at home all year. And some stinky teams are coming in here. Now, that makes me almost more nervous than if they were playing good teams, because they've kind of had this tendency all year, the weekend aside, to play up or down to their level of competition, which I think happens in sports a lot more than people realize. You always think your own team is the one that does that, and everybody does that.
Do you think the media has made too much of winning 82, too little of winning 82? How are the average fans feel out there? I got out my Aki Iwamura head on a stick today in honor of some of the horrible moments we've all witnessed baseball-wise in the last 20
years. You know what? When I saw the cover, the great cover for the sports section of the Trib today with the big 82 on it, I'm thinking, did any Pirate ever wear the number 82? And I looked it up. Last thing's millage was 85. I don't know if you remember that, but there was no 82. No, I don't think the media has made too much of it, because most of the media have lived through all of this, too. This has been a long time. The fans are – and I come in today, and one of the custodial workers downstairs, and he said, Bucco's guy, Bucco's. That's all he said as I walked in the lobby, and people are talking about him everywhere. And they have experienced this. People were popping champagne. This meant something to people. So you can't ignore that. The media's job isn't to make the news. It's to cover what's happening, and people everywhere are talking. Talking about it. I think fans are handling it the way you would expect them to handle, and the team is handling it the way they should handle it. It's not a big deal. They want to win the division. It's great. They celebrated like they did any of the other 81 wins that they had this year.
But yet Andrew McCutchen had the eyes on the sky.
I mean, I was on this one on the radio. I didn't see the last out.
Well, you know, these guys have to deal with those questions. So
yeah.
If nothing else.
Yeah,
he
wasn't celebrating the end of 20 years of losing. He was celebrating the end of every spring training. Is this the year you break the jinx? Yeah. That question's gone now.
Well, that's a step, and for those guys, it's got to feel like an accomplishment, and maybe that will buoy them into a nice homestand, because let's face it, they've had 4 poor starts before Cole rights the ship last night, and that's taken some of the luster off the momentum into 82 from 81. If they had done that in St. Louis, I think people would be even more excited, but there's still a skepticism of whether they can even hold off the Washington Nationals. You won't believe anything until you see it now with this franchise.
Yeah. Well, they had 3 excellent months, Ken. They ended the month of June on a 9-game winning streak. Last night means they're exactly .500 since the 1st of July. So, you know, that's kind of, I don't want to say floundering, but it's important and significant in what has happened the last 2 years. Very similar. They didn't get all the way through 3 of months of excellence. The wheels started to fall off earlier, and you'd have been happy if they could have finished. I mean, how many times did we say, and from Memorial Day to the 4th of July, if they can just go .500 the rest of the way, they're going to win 92 games. If they just go .500 the rest of the way, they're going to win 94 games. Well, they've just gone .500 the rest of the way, and they're on pace to win, 91, 92 games.
Yeah. Can they win 8 of the last 19 to get to 90?
Yeah.
That would be an unbelievable season in the whole grand scheme of it. And they got through a lot of adversity, some ups and downs. They've got another spot of it here. We'll see how Liriano bounces back tonight. That may decide the fate of their postseason success, whether Liriano tonight wins 83 or whether he continues on the downward slide that he's been on.
Well, each pitcher has had a different story this year, whether they've been a long-term hot, long-term cold, injury, this or that. Garrett Cole's been the one guy that really, we talked about it yesterday, every game's the same. He gives up 2 or 3 runs. That's it. And, some games they don't hit, which has basically made him a .500 pitcher or so because of the way they hit. Last night he was dominant. I mean, he went head-to-head with one of the best pitchers in baseball, despite having trouble the last month. Darvish is tiring out. There's no question about that, but he kept them in that game until they could squeak one lousy run across. And I don't care which pitchers are hot by the time the month ends, as long as someone is. If Liriano poops out a little bit now, maybe Burnett comes back, maybe Locke regains a little bit of his first half magic after having some rest, maybe Cole is really coming in, maybe Cole is one of those guys that, because of his size, strength, and youth, is still bringing it at 98 miles an hour in October, where the other guys can't do that anymore.
Doug Drabek finally passed the baton to Garrett Cole. It only took 20 years. And a guy that's young enough to be his son. Guy Junker, Ken Laird, Trib Live Radio.